In this video, I'll be doing a complete example on how to install and configure Influx and Telegraph to ingest Modbus data into your Influx database. Now, if you're not familiar with Telegraph, it works in conjunction with Influx, and it has a plugin system to bring in different types of factory data. In this case, we'll be using the Modbus plugin, but there are a host of other plugins available. The learning curve is a little steep with Telegraph, and you have to edit a very large configuration file. So I found an easy way to go about doing this, and I'm going to demonstrate that for you today. All right, we'll start by installing InfluxDB. So I'm just opening a terminal and shelling into the Edge computer. From there, we're going to run this Docker command, and I'll put all the links in the description below. This will allow you to access the device at port 8086, and just go through the installation wizard, set up your initial user and password and organization and bucket as shown here. This next command will create a default configuration file, and it's really useful because it gives you a lot of documentation about the different plugins that are available. So if I do a nano with this name of this file, you can see this is a 10,000 line file, and there's a lot of commented lines with the hashtag. So if you do a control W, you can search the document. And so if you search for influxdb_v2, that brings you down to this section here, and this is where you can configure your connection to the bucket you created. It requires an organization and a token. The next part is the Modbus under the input section. So again, you can go and you can uncomment these lines. The problem is this file is so large that it really becomes difficult to manage. So what we're going to do is we're going to SCP into the root device and grab that file and bring it into my local machine. So to do that, I'm just going to open another tab here, and I'm going to execute this SCP with the user and address for the remote device and the file, and then bring that file over. And so you can see that it's copied the file locally. And this makes it much easier when you can use something like Visual Studio Code to do your text editing. So I've just created a new file called telegraph.conf, and I'm just copying over all of the relevant lines that are not commented. And it's much easier to deal with a 50-line document than a 10,000-line document. So, you know, here in this section, I need to copy the token ID to make the secure connection to my Influx. So I'm just creating an API key. I'm going to copy that and just, you know, paste it right into that section, which is making the connection, you know, to the InfluxDB and bucket and organization that I've set up earlier. And then down here is the input plugin section for the Modbus. So you'll see things like IP address and the configuration type. And these sections here are reading in the coils and the holding registers. So just have to reference the IP address, you know, the register, and then give it a name. So now that I'm done editing that file and I've saved it off, I can use SCP to copy it back to the Edge device. So I'm just using SCP, as you can see here. And then I'm going to go back to my shell and do an ls on the device. And you can see that it did copy the telegraph.conf file. So now I'll run the Docker command to start Telegraph referencing that configuration file. And we can make sure that it started up okay using Docker container ls. So I've got Influx and Telegraph running now. And then if I do a docker logs -f telegraph, I can monitor the log file in real time. This will tell you if there's a problem loading the configuration file. It'll reference which line it had a problem with, or if the device goes offline. Now, if I go to Data Explorer and Chronograph, I should see the new measurement for Modbus and the new variables that I added in the configuration file. So I'll just select the button and the RTD that I have wired up and click Submit, and I can see the data coming in real time in the graph. So as you can see, working with Telegraph just requires a little bit of knowledge about Docker and editing configuration files. I think it's an interesting way to bring data into InfluxDB without any real programming. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.